Recap what we studied in last class. We started with some continuous time signal x of t. After that, we sampled that at a rate of fs. Fs equals to 1 by ts. Ts is the sampling period, x of nts, where n is integer, n belongs to z. And after that, we try to convert this into digital form. This is a digital signal, x of n, square brackets for this, where n is integer. That can be positive integer, that can be zero, or that can be a negative integer, this n. Let's consider, for example, x of t equals to cos omega t plus pi. This is capital omega. Analog frequency in radians per second, capital omega. Pi is in radians, this is a phase, where omega equals to 2 pi f, f is in hertz or second inverse. Once we do sampling, uniform sampling with a period of ts, for every ts we are doing sampling, then we are going to get x of nts equals to cos omega into nts plus pi. And if I try to simplify this one, I am going to get this finally, x of n equals to cos omega n plus pi, where omega is known as digital frequency and the units are radians per sample. Radians per sample, the other units per digital frequency, small omega, where omega equals to 2 pi f by fs. Fs is the sampling rate. And as we know that major frequency of the message signal should be less than or equal to fs by 2. See, major frequency less than or equal to fs by 2 means all the frequencies in that message signal should be less than or equal to fs by 2 in order to avoid aliasing effect. Where fs is the sampling rate. And if you try to multiply with 2 pi divided by fs, then we are going to end up with this expression, that digital frequency should be less than or equal to pi. Pi radians per sample, the highest possible digital frequency. And one more thing is, cos omega naught plus 2 pi k into n is nothing but cos omega naught n. This is valid for all n and for all k. They are integers. Yeah, can someone justify this one? Is it true or false, this statement? The claim is, I have cos omega naught n with me. What I am trying to do is replacing omega naught with omega naught plus 2 pi k, where k is integer. And I am claiming that this is equals to cos omega naught n itself. For all n comma k belongs to integers. Is it true? What is cos theta plus 2 pi k? Cos theta plus 2 pi k, what is that? Again, interact, right? What is this? Cos theta one, right? Cos theta plus 2 pi k is nothing but cos theta. When k is integer, k should be integer. It can be positive integer, negative integer, or anything. It should be integer. K should be integer. Same thing, right? This can be written as cos omega naught n plus 2 pi k n. Is it integer k into n? I am claiming that this is an integer. Is it true? I know that,
yes, sir.
N is integer, k is integer. Then what about kn? Is it integer? Yes, someone answered right. Is it integer?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's integer, right? For example, I'll take k equal to 2, n equal to 3. 2 into 3 is 6, right? 6 also integer. When this is 2, when this is integer multiple of 2 pi, theta plus something, when this something is integer multiple of 2 pi, then that is same as cos theta. See, just integer multiple of 2 pi, right? 2 pi into some integer, integer multiple of 2 pi. Then that is same as cos omega naught n itself. This is valid for all n and k. And there should be integers, n and k. This is valid for all n and k, right? And then, yeah, what is the meaning of this? What you got from this statement? Omega naught and omega naught plus 2 pi k, where k is an integer. Yeah, what's the claim? The two are identical, right? You can try to see this. What we proved is cos of omega naught plus 2 pi k into n is nothing but cos omega naught n. So see, the coefficient of n is the digital frequency, right? According to our terminology, is what we are following. The omega we are calling like digital frequency in radians per sample. According to our terminology, the coefficient of n within these brackets, cosine of this one, that corresponds to digital frequency. The coefficient of n in our expression is this only, right? This is our coefficient of n, omega naught plus 2 pi k. And the coefficient of n here is omega naught. These two are identical means omega naught digital frequency is behaving exactly same as omega naught plus 2 pi k. I can try to say that omega naught plus 2 pi k digital frequency is exactly behaving like this omega naught frequency, right? Digital frequency. They are exactly identical, the two sequences. Up to that we can get it. They are equivalent almost. It means, can you say the cos omega naught n is periodic with a period of 2 pi? Is it true? When my parameter is omega naught, I am claiming that cos omega naught n is periodic with period 2 pi. When the variable is omega naught. In this case, n is fixed. Let's assume like that one. Here my variable is omega naught. This omega naught is my variable. Then can I claim like this? This is periodic with a period of 2 pi. Because see, cos of omega naught plus 2 pi into n is nothing but cos omega naught n. The periodic with a period of 2 pi. And this will repeat for every 2 pi, right? K equal to 1 means 2 pi. K equal to 2 means 2 into 2 pi. K equal to 3 means 3 into 2 pi. The periodic with a period of 2 pi. This digital frequency is periodic with a period of 2 pi. With this period. Both are behaving exactly in the same manner, right? Those two frequencies. So omega naught plus 2 pi k digital frequency is same as omega naught for all k belongs to z. We can consider only omega belongs to 0 to 2 pi or omega belongs to minus pi to pi as unique digital frequencies. See, the reason for this one is omega naught is periodic with a period of 2 pi. With the period of 2 pi means at max 2 pi interval we can consider, right, as unique frequencies. One way is we can consider either 0 to 2 pi or minus pi to pi. Yeah, which one might be preferable according to your guess? Is there any guess? I'm giving two options to you. The unique possible digital frequencies, if you want, you can consider like this 0 to 2 pi interval or minus pi to pi interval also. Which one might be comfortable for you? Minus pi to pi or 0 to 2 pi? If you want, I will give you a hint to you. Earlier, in order to avoid aliasing effect, we followed F should be less than or equal to Fs by 2. And finally, we ended up with what is the frequency, digital frequency? Highest digital frequency. Yeah, what is the highest digital frequency that we climbed earlier? Pi, right? That should be pi. Yeah, someone is asking here. That is pi, right? It means it's better to go with this notation. It's more or less convenient to us. We like to construct these digital frequencies as unique frequencies. Unique frequencies. Every 2 pi they will repeat, right? These are unique frequencies, digital frequencies. This is our claim. In a similar manner, we can have same result for sin omega naught t, e power j omega naught t. This is complex exponential. And e power minus j omega naught t. And with the phase shift of pi. Oh, okay. By mistake, I mentioned it like t. You can consider this like n. T means t belongs to real space, right? Try to replace this t with n, small n. This is a digital, right? Replace this with n. Still, you can have the same thing, same property for this. This is equally valid for this also. Omega naught is periodic with a period of 2 pi. That omega naught will repeat for every 2 pi. The behavior is same for this. But for analog signal, if you increase omega, the frequency of oscillation keeps on increasing. Is it true or false? If you consider analog signal as 2 pi f t, if I keep on increasing my f, is it periodic with f? My question is it periodic with respect to f? Where for all t belongs to R. Is it true or false? See, here this is not periodic. If you keep on increasing frequency, the number of oscillations per second will keep on increasing. The oscillations will keep on increasing till infinity. If f tends to infinity, number of oscillations per second also tends to infinity. But that's not the case with digital frequency. If you keep on increasing this frequency, then let it repeat, right? For example, frequency pi is same as pi plus 2 pi. 3 pi and pi, both are same frequencies, digital frequencies. And if I consider pi by 2, pi by 2 plus 2 pi and pi by 2, both are same. And if I add one more 2 pi, still that is same. The behavior of that pattern, cos omega naught n pattern remains same. But that's not the case with continuous time case. Frequency of oscillations keeps on increasing as you increase f. But for digital case, what happens is, yeah, up to what frequency the frequency of oscillations will increase? I already have a sketch of analog. This is analog frequency versus frequency of oscillations, the number of cycles per second. If I increase this f, the frequency of oscillations also will keep on increasing. Indefinitely that will go. If I increase further and further. See for analog case. When coming to digital, if any guess, I'll try to have this. Zero. According to our guess, earlier guess, minus pi to pi. There should be unique frequencies, right? Unique frequencies, minus pi to pi. And this will repeat for every 2 pi. What happens to this one? Up to omega naught equals to pi, up to omega equals to pi, these are unique frequencies, and the frequency of oscillations keeps on increasing up to pi. This keeps on increasing up to pi. After pi, what happens is the frequency of oscillations will decrease up to 2 pi. Like this, we are going to get. Yeah, I'll try to write it fully. When coming to digital, it's 0. Let me start 0. This is pi. And this is 2 pi. And once again, frequency of oscillations will increase up to this point 3 pi, and it will decrease up to 4 pi. This is omega versus frequency of oscillations, number of cycles per second. Like that, you can think. This is 5 pi, this is 6 pi, and so on. Like this, you can expect. Can you guess the reason for this? We already saw that omega naught is same as, is equivalent to, is equivalent, equivalent to omega naught plus 2 pi k, where k is integer. With this scenario, what about zero? Yeah, you can substitute into this one. Omega naught equal to zero, is it same as omega naught equals to 2 pi? Is it true or false? See, what's our actual thing is omega naught is same as omega naught plus 2 pi k. When coming to digital, and coming to digital frequencies, I am considering omega naught equal to 0. 0 is same as 0 plus 2 pi k, right? Where k is integer. Where k is integer, it means if 0 is same as 2 pi, and that is same as 4 pi, that is same as 6 pi. They are identical. I can have this, right? Cos of this one is nothing but cos of omega naught plus 2 pi k. They are identical. Omega naught n plus 2 pi k. These two are identical. Let me have this. Yeah, these two are identical. I am doing the same thing. This is the number of frequency of oscillations for this is same as frequency of oscillations. And that is same as frequency of oscillation for this one. At, you can try to see this one. At a very multiple of 2 pi, at every integer multiple of 2 pi, that is nothing but same as your 0. Similarly for pi, pi is equivalent to which frequency? When omega naught equal to pi, pi is same as pi plus 2 pi k. It means 2k plus 1 into pi, where k belongs to z. What I had on it, 2 pi k plus pi. Here omega naught equals to pi I consider omega naught equal to pi. Then pi is same as pi plus 2 pi k. It means that is 2 k plus 1 into pi, where k belongs to z. For every odd multiple of pi, is odd multiple of pi. Even multiple of pi corresponds to 0. Result we can see of 0, even multiple of pi means. Odd multiple of pi corresponds to pi. Odd multiple of pi is nothing but highest possible digital frequency. That's the reason we are going to have the same thing, right? At 3 pi, this is repeating. You can see the oscillations are same for both because they are identical. Similarly, at 5 pi, these three are equal. This one is same as this one, is same as this one, right? These three are equal. In a similar manner, you can try to have intuition over this, right? For example, pi by 2. I will consider pi by 2. According to this statement, pi by 2 should be same as pi by 2 plus 2 pi k, right? Let me consider k equal to 1. K equals to 1 means, what should be that one? 2 pi plus pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, right? 5 pi by 2 is somewhere here. You can try to have a look into this one. The two are identical. And by default, they are identical. The frequency of oscillations are the same, right? You can have a look into this. And similarly, when you substitute k equal to 2, then you are going to end up somewhere here. This is, yeah, what is this? 4 pi plus pi by 2, 9 pi by 2. The 9 pi by 2, right? The oscillations remain same for them, right? In a similar manner, you can try for others also. Then what about this? Why these two are same? Is any guess? Forget about plus 2 pi. Why this one is same as this one? Is there any reason behind this? Yeah, why those two are equal? By default, if you do plus 2 pi k, it's fine. And what about this? Why this one is same as this one? Up to this, there is no issue. This one is same as this one, same as that one, because plus 2 pi into 2, k equal to, right? Yeah, like that. It'll go this side also in the same manner. It'll go negative side also, exactly in the similar lines. Okay, I'll try to ask a question. Yes, what is this? What is cos 2 pi minus theta? Yes, what is cos 2 pi minus theta? Cos theta, right? Yes, it's good. That is nothing but cos theta. Then what about omega naught? Let me have 2 pi minus omega naught. Omega naught into n equals to cos 2 pi n minus omega naught n. Yeah, what about this? Cos 2 pi n minus omega naught n. What is this? Yeah, you can speak, no problem. Typing might be difficult for this. You can speak. This is nothing but cos omega naught n, where n is integer, right? Nothing but cos omega naught n. That's what we are doing here. Omega naught, we are trying to have equivalent manner in this way. 2 pi minus omega naught, these two are equal. This is pi by 2. If I do 2 pi minus pi by 2, omega naught is same as 2 pi minus omega naught, right? 2 pi minus pi by 2 means 3 pi by 2. That's the reason these two are equal. Like that you can think. Now, the overall thing you need to remember is this part. Forget about the other parts. At least you can try to have like, if I increase my digital frequency omega, the frequency of oscillations will increase up to pi, omega not equal to pi. And after that, they'll try to decrease, right? Pi to 2 pi, the frequency of oscillations are keeps on decreasing. And once again, frequency of oscillations will increase, decrease like this. And my question is, what is the highest possible digital frequency? Oscillations, frequency of oscillations. Yeah, which one corresponds to this? This frequency. Omega equal to highest one, highest ask questions. Is it at even multiple of pi or at odd multiple of pi? Odd multiple, right? Yes, it's true. At odd multiple of pi, you can have a look into this figure. At pi, 3 pi, 5 pi, and so on. At odd multiple of pi, we are getting highest possible frequency of oscillations. Omega equals to 2k plus 1 into pi. For all k belongs to z. At odd multiple of pi, and lowest possible oscillations, lowest possible oscillations at even multiple of pi, 2k into pi, for all k integer. Can you have a look into this? Lowest possible oscillations at 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi, this side minus 2 pi, minus 4 pi, and so on. At even multiple of pi, the even multiple of pi, right? At even multiple of pi, we are going to get the lowest possible frequency of oscillations for the digital case. And this is the basic required for our digital signal processing course. Let us have a look into the graphical view of some of the signals. This is cos omega naught n, where omega naught equal to 0 or omega naught equal to 2 pi. If you want, you can cross check. Let's substitute omega naught equal to 0 in this. Cos 0 n is nothing but cos 0. Cos 0 is always 1, right? Or if I go with cos 2 pi n, cos 2 pi n is always 1. Cos 2 pi n is always 1. It's almost like a DC, right? Is it looking like a DC component? If I try to fill this gap, it might be looking like a DC, right? DC in digital way. Like that, you can have a view of that, right? It's almost, this is constant for all values of n, for all indices n. Yeah, why these two frequencies are equal? This is omega naught equal to pi by 8. Omega naught equal to pi by 8 or 15 pi by 8. Why these two are equal? I just gave some logic to you, right? Can you guess? Why pi by 8 and 15 pi by 8 are giving identical signal? This is cos omega naught n, where omega naught equal to pi by 8 or 15 pi by 8. Pi by 8 n equals to yes, why this is true? For all n belongs to integer. Yeah, you can speak. There's no issue, right? You can turn on microphone. Just now we have seen this, right? This pi by 8 is equivalent to 2 pi minus pi by 8. They two are similar, right? As we suggest now, 2 pi minus pi by 8 is nothing but 15 pi by 8. 15 pi by 8. These two are equal. And if you go for omega naught equal to pi by 4, this is pi by 4. Pi by 4 and 7 pi by 4 are same, because 7 pi by 4 is nothing but 2 pi minus pi by 4. And this corresponds to omega naught equal to pi. Omega naught equal to pi means cos pi n. For n equal to 0, Yes. Can you just tell me cos pi n? There's some special interest over this. Omega not equal to pi. Yes, what is this? Can I write like this? Is it true or false?
True, sir.
Minus 1 whole power n, right? It's true. Because for n equal to 0, cos 0 is 1. For n equal to 1, cos pi is minus 1. Minus 1 whole power 1, that's minus 1, the same as this, right? For n equal to 2, cos 2 pi is 1. Cos 2 pi is 1. Minus 1 whole square, that is 1, right? Minus 1 whole power n. The alternate positive negative, right? Alternate positive negative. Highest possible frequency of oscillations. That's pi. You can have a look into this one. Just cross-check this one and this one. In which case you are having more oscillations. More oscillations means positive to negative transitions are within short time. Where you are finding? Is first one or second one? Second one, right? You can have a look into this one. See, if you have a look into this, this is zero, positive, 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 and this is negative. Negative, negative, zero, and positive. This is taking more number of samples, at least three samples, 3 to 4 samples, to become positive to negative, right? This to this one. This is, in this case, alternate sample itself is negative. Alternate sample is negative, positive, like that. You are looking to this. This is positive, negative, negative, like that. It keeps on oscillating, right? It's the highest possible frequency of oscillations. Just adjacent samples, we are changing the sign. The highest possible oscillations we are going to expect from the digital, right? Intuitively also can match with this pi. And you can have a look into all these things. There are no oscillations at all for omega not equal to zero. Zero oscillations. This is constant for all n, right? And if you increase this slightly, pi by 8, the oscillations, there are some oscillations for this. Here there is no oscillation at all. Here there are some oscillations, right? And if you increase the frequency further, pi by 4, the oscillations increased. You can have a look into this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 samples. After 8 samples, you got negative. In this case, just after 4 samples, you got negative. Oscillations are more for this, right? Positive to negative transition, negative to positive transition. A bit quicker, quick as compared to that pi by 8. And oscillation keeps on increasing up to pi. This is matching to our analysis, right? Whatever the analysis that we had done, it's matching to that one. You can try to see 0 to pi. If it keeps on increasing that frequency, the oscillations are keeps on increasing, as we saw in these examples. In these examples, and after that, the oscillation should decrease. Oscillation should decrease, right? After pi, the oscillation should decrease till 2 pi. That thing you can see here. This is 7 pi by 4, 7 pi by 4, and this is 15 pi by 8. 15 pi by 8 is bigger than 7 pi by 4. And oscillations for 15 pi by 8 are less compared to 7 pi by 8, right? As we saw in this. Yeah, you can try to have a look into this. Compared to 7 pi by 4 oscillations, oscillation for 15 pi by 8 are bit less, but this frequency is bigger compared to that one. That's also matching here, right? 7 pi by 8 is somewhere, yeah. 7 pi by 8 is somewhere here, and 15 pi by 8 is somewhere here. That's matching to this one, right? It's decreasing after 2 pi, and again increases, and so on. That oscillations. These figures are from discrete time signal passing by Oppenheim. And you can have a look into this. It means for digital case, the low frequencies are nothing but the frequencies which are nearby even multiple of pi. Even multiple of pi means 2 pi k, where k is some integer. The k can be 0 also, right? And highest possible digital frequencies are nearby odd multiple of pi. It's nothing but 2k plus 1 into pi, right? Where k belongs to z. Let us have a look into periodicity of discrete time signals. Smallest positive integer n, this is capital N, for which x of n plus n equals to x of n. And this is valid for all small integer n. It is called as fundamental period of x of n. Self-definition. Let us have some examples for this. In digital case, x of n plus n should be same as x of n for all n belongs to z, where capital N also belongs to z. This should be integer. Here this should be positive integer. Should be positive integer, then you can call n as fundamental period. You can call n as a period. The period of the signal sequence x of n. The period of the sequence x of n. N also should be integer. Capital N also should be integer. This you need to remember. But what about continuous case? X of t plus t should be equals to x of t for all t belongs to real. And what should be t? T can be any real, right? T need not be integer. T can be any real. Then you can call t as time period. Period of this signal x of t. When coming to continuous time case, this can be any real value. But for our digital case, this period should be an integer. This you need to remember, that should be an integer. Let me go with some example. Pass pi n by 4. X of n equals to cos pi n by 4. I need to find capital N in such a manner that x of n plus n equals to x of n. The smallest possible such n is known as fundamental period. The smallest possible capital N which satisfies this condition is known as fundamental period. Cos pi by 4 into n plus n. Replacing n with n plus n, right? Equals to cos pi by 4 n plus pi by 4 n. When this is equals to this one, can someone answer this? When? What is that n? Yes, what is this? Where k is some integer. Yeah, what is this? You can speak, right? What is cos pi by 4 n plus 2 pi k, where k is some integer. What is this? What is cos theta plus 2 pi k? Cos theta only, right? Yeah, that's what we can have here. See, cos pi by 4n plus 2 pi k is nothing but cos pi by 4n. It means that second term we are going to have, that should be something like this, 2 pi k, right? Whatever the second term we are having here, this second term should be equal to 2 pi into some integer. This pi by 4n should be something of this form, where k is integer. And we should require n to be integer. This should be integer. This pi gets cancelled out. Implies n equals to 8k. Then what is the fundamental period? Yes, what is the fundamental period? See, fundamental period is nothing but, yeah, someone, yeah, they answered already, right? 8. The smallest possible integer n, right? Capital N. Smallest possible integer. Where k can be any integer. And that should be positive integer. For example, k equal to 1, 2, 3. Like this, you can substitute. For k equal to 1, this is 8. For k equal to 2, this is 16. For k equal to 3, that is 24. And so on, right? The smallest integer I'll consider as fundamental period. In this case, smallest possible thing is 8. For that is valid for k equal to 1 only, right? This is my fundamental period. This can be called as period. It's a period, right? It's a period of that sequence because x of n plus n equals to x of n. And this is called as fundamental period, least possible one. It's a fundamental period. This can be called as period. It means the period of this one can be 8, 16, 24, 32, and so on, right? All of them are periods because if I do this n plus n, I am going to get x of n. For all these n, for any one of them, I am going to get this, right? They are called as period, but fundamental period means the least possible one out of them. Okay, it's fine. Cos pi by 4n, we had an. Cos 3 pi n by 8. What is the period of this? Fundamental period of this one. The least possible one we need to find. We need to satisfy this condition and this should be integer. It means we require cos 3 pi by 8. Replace n with n plus n. And if we split that one, we are going to get 3 pi by 8 into n. And if you want to satisfy this condition, for all small n integer. You want to satisfy this condition. This should be equal to how much? Yes, at least you can respond now, right? What
should happen?
This should be equal to? Yeah, that should be equal to
2 pi k, sir.
2 pi k, right? Yes, that should be equal to 2 pi k. If that is equal to 2 pi k, then it's okay for us, right? Let us have 3 pi by 8 into n equals to 2 pi k implies n equals to pi gets cancelled out. N equal to 16 k by 3, where k can be 1, 2, 3 and so on. I need to find smallest possible integer n out of them. That's my fundamental period. What is that? N equal to fundamental period. How much?
16.
That's good. 16. We are going to get fundamental period 16 when k equal to 3, right? For k equal to 1, this is 16 by 3. That's not an integer. For k equal to 2, that is 32 by 3. And that is not an integer. For k equal to 3, this 3 gets cancelled out and we are going to get 16. This is an integer, right? The smallest possible integer we are going to get is the fundamental period of this. Is it looking odd to you? You can try to have a look into this. Which one is, which is having more frequency, pi by 4 or 3 pi by 8?
3 pi by 8.
3 100, 3 pi by 8, and first one we can study pi by 4. Pi by 4 is nothing but 2 pi by 8. Okay. 2 pi by 8 less than 3 pi by 8. And when you look into continuous time case, continuous time case, f1t, this is your first frequency, cos 2 pi f2t, the second one. If f1 greater than f2, or if f1 less than f2, then what happens to time period, fundamental time period? What is the relation? When coming to analog case, T1 is nothing but 1 by F1, right? And T2 is nothing but 1 by F2. If F1 less than F2, then T1 greater than T2. Because you are doing 1 divided by this one, right? Less than becomes like greater than. The opposite should happen, right? But what we got here is, for pi by 4, we got a period of n equal to how much period we got? 8, right? For second case, we got 16. For this case, we got 16. You can see, this is low frequency, this is high frequency. High frequency got low period. And low frequency got, what's happening here? According to this continuous time case, based on this one, high frequency should get less time period, low frequency should get high time period. But when coming to digital case, it's also possible. It means that it's not always true. For some of the frequency components, it's possible that high frequency will have high period as compared to low frequency. It's possible. It doesn't mean that it's always true. In this particular case, it came like that. But that need not be true all the time. It's possible for the digital case. That digital looks a bit odd, right? As compared to that continuous. Cos n. Okay, what about this one? Let me consider x of n equals to cos n. And I am expecting like this, x of n plus n equals to cos of n plus n. When this is true, when this is true,
n equal to 2 pi, sir.
This should be equal to 2 pi k, right? This is 2 pi k is equals to cos theta. Implies we require capital N equals to 2 pi k, where k is some integer. 1, 2, 3, and so on. 1, 2, 3, and so on. Positive integers. Can someone give me the least positive integer n in this case? Yeah, what is the least positive integer? Is it integer for k equal to 1? For k equal to 1, that is 2 pi. For k equal to 2, that is 4 pi. Yeah, what is the least possible integer we are going to get? Yes, what is the least possible integer? We can't get an integer as pi is irrational. Yeah, it's true. We can't get an integer. See, whatever the pi we studied, like 22 by 7, this is not exact. This is an approximation. If this is exact one, then what we are going to do is, for k equal to 7, 7 gets cancelled out. Then we are going to get 44. If this is exact one, but this is not exact one. This is an approximation to pi. The approximation to pi. Pi is an irrational number. That means with the help of multiplication with integer, we will never make it like integer. We will never make it this part like an integer. It's not possible for any integer key. This is known as aperiodic. Aperiodic. It's not a periodic. It's aperiodic. Cos n is not periodic. But what about cos t? Is it periodic or aperiodic? Answer continuous time base. Is it periodic or aperiodic? Cos t. Cos n is aperiodic. Because we require period to be integer. Then what about cos t when we construct it? Periodic, right? What is the period of that one? 2 pi, right? Cos t plus 2 pi is nothing but cos t for all t. Because here any real number is allowed, right? When coming to continuous case, any real number is allowed. But when coming to discrete case, that should be an integer. Because that sequence is defined only at integer values of n, right? That should be defined only at integer values of n. That is undefined at non-integer values of that index. Yeah, that's one of the differences as you compare with that continuous case. And what about this one? Cos pi n by 4 plus cos 3 pi n by 8. This is my x of n. What I require is x of n plus n should be equal to x of n. It means what I need to satisfy here is pi n by 4 plus pi n by 4. I am replacing small n with n plus n in this expression. Equals to, I should get exactly equal to this thing, this whole thing. For that, I have to satisfy this. This should be 2 pi into some integer, and this also should be some 2 pi into integer. 2 pi into some integer. Just to avoid confusion, let me consider 2 pi into k1. 2 pi into k2, where k1, k2 should be integers. It means pi n by 4 equal to 2 pi k1, 2 pi k1 and 3 pi n by 8 equals to 2 pi k2, where k1 k2 are integers, implies pi gets cancelled out. I'm going to get 8 k1, pi gets cancelled out, implies n equals to 8 k2 divided by 3, where k1 equals to 1 2 3 and so on, k2 equals to 1 2 3 and so on. Yeah, what is the n I am going to get here? Let me call it like, yeah, what is the n I am going to get here? Forget about this part. What should be the smallest possible digit? 8, right? Next one is 16. For k1 equal to 1, 8. For k1 equals to 2, 16. For k1 equal to 3, I am going to get 24 and so on. Like this, I am going to get. This is not fundamental period. It's a period. I am talking about period. It's not fundamental period. Fundamental period means 8 for this one, for this first part. For this second part, yeah, what will be my n possible integers? Yes, you should respond, right? 8k2 by 3. What is the least possible integer? 8, right? Yes. That is 8. For k equal to k2 equals to 3, 3 gets cancelled out. I'm getting 8. What is the next possible thing? K2 equal to 4, there is no cancellation. Once again at k2 equal to 6. K2 equal to 6, I'm going to get 3 gets cancelled out. 16 I am getting, right? And so on. Like this I am getting. Then what is the period of this one, fundamental period of is it true or false? Is there any mistake here?
Yes, sir. There will be left to 2, sir.
Okay, this is 16, right? This should be 16. It means this is 16. Next one is how much? Next one? For k2 equal to 3, I am getting integer. Once again, for k2 equal to 6, I am going to get 32. That's an integer. And so on, right? Like this, I am going to get. I'll have to list out all the possible periods. Then, what is my final n? Is there any guess? What is my final one?
LCM, maybe.
Okay, that's true. N is LCM of this fundamental period 8 and this fundamental period 16. What is this value?
16, sir.
16, right? LCM, least common multiplier. 16 by 8, we are going to get a 0 remainder. Remainder at 0, right? That's the least common multiplier. And 16 by 16, that's also finite. Perfect. It's 16, right? That should be 16. According to this intuition, can someone say why that is 16? It's a reason. We should get x of n plus capital N should be equal to x of n. Suppose if I go with 8, if I go with 8, what I am going to get is this first part will be same as this one. If capital N equal to 8, this will be identical to this one. But second part is not equal to this part, right? If I go with 8. Now, if I go with 16, both are satisfying, right? If I go with 16, these two are satisfying. With N equal to 16, this is same as this one. And with n equal to 16, this is same as this one. It's exactly matching, right? That will work for both. 16 will work for both, right? Or you can go with this also. This also fine.